Hi friends, I am Ashok Kumar Sahu. Hope my session finds you in a good health. So today I will be discussing about the rural value chain management. In this I will be using one PowerPoint presentation to discuss all the concepts related to this subject. The objectives are, at the end of the session the participants will be able to understand the value chain concept, understand about the value chain management and the value chain analysis, understand the basics of the rural value chain. And the expected learning outcomes are, the participants will be able to understand the meaning and the concept of value chain at the end of the session and understand what is the importance of value chain in our day-to-day life. So then coming to the value chain concept. The value chain concept was first given by Michael Porter in his book Competitive Advantage in the year 1985. You must be wondering what is the meaning of the term or the book's name Competitive Advantage. Competitive advantage is a condition or circumstance that puts a company in a favorable or superior business position as compared to its competitors. As per the definition given by Michael Porter, value chain is a collection of all such activities that are performed by a company to create value for its customers. It basically means the value creation. What is the meaning of value creation? Value creation is adding value to a product. This added value also gives rise to higher profitability for a firm. A more elaborate definition was given by Mr. Kapilskaya in the year 2000. According to him, a value chain is the full range of activities which are required to bring a product or service from conception through the intermediary phases of production, delivery to final consumers, and final disposal after use. So in simple terms, we can say that value chain is a process in which a company adds value to its raw material and finally sells it to its consumer. This is the simplest definition of the value chain concept. These are the fundamental activities in a manufacturing organization. First comes the raw material, then it is the processing of raw material and then packaging that final processed product into the finished goods and then delivering it to the consumers. Then this is the Porter's value chain model. Porter divided all the activities into primary and support activities. The primary activities includes inbound logistics, operations, outbound logistics, marketing and sales, service. And the support activities includes procurement, technology development, human resource and firm industries. We will be discussing them in details one by one. According to him, primary activities is pretty direct on the production, processing, sales, support of the goods or services to be supplied. Whereas the support activities are those activities who assist the primary activities and form the basis of any organization. So now we will be discussing the primary activities. First comes the inbound logistics. What are inbound logistics? These are all activities that are involved in the receiving, storing and internal distribution of the raw material or basic ingredients of a product or service. For example, transportation, material handling, material storage, vehicle scheduling, returns to suppliers, communications, testing and others. Then comes the operation or the production. In these activities, the inputs of products and services are converted into semi-finished or finished products. Some examples are like machining, packaging, assembly equipment maintenance, testing, printing and facility operations. Then comes the outbound logistics. In outbound logistics, all activities related to final product and service delivery to the customer will fall under this category. For example, storage and the distribution system, Then comes the marketing and sales. All such activities and processes which help put the finished product or service in the market would fall under this category. This would also include managing and generating customer relationship. The guiding principle are fixing goals that are different from the competition and creating additional benefits for the customers. Channel relation, promotion, sales force, quoting, channel selection, advertisement and pricing. Then comes the after sales services. This would include all the activities which involve maintenance of the value of the product or service for the customers as soon as the relation develops post procurement of the service and products. This may include spare part supply, product adjustment, installation, training and repair. Then comes the firm infrastructure. This falls under support activities. Firm infrastructure concerns the support activities with the organization that helps the organization to maintain its routine operations. Example, administrative handling, financial and line management are good example of such activities which create value for the organization. And then comes the human resource management. It deals with various activities like training, recruiting of the staff, retaining of the staff, motivating of the staff through different types of training. So it is a very important part of any organization. Then comes the technology development, which we can also call as research and development, R&D in short. All such activities that pertain to the development of the products and services of the organization, both internally and externally, can be kept under these categories. For example, IT technological innovations and improvement and the development of new products based on new technologies. These activities create value using innovation and optimization. Then comes the procurement. This refers to all the support activities related to the procurement of material and services essential to service the customer by our producers. So, firms use primary and support activities as the foundation to create the value in the product, service and the service distinctiveness. So, in the next video, we will be covering the value chain management. Thank you.